Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh channel. In this tutorial, we will use React Native Linear Gradient in the background of the page and button, and we learn how to implement any type of gradient. And finally, we implement a button from CSS style. For those who have no idea about gradient, a gradient lets you display smooth transitions between two or more specified colors. The gradient can be of two types, linear gradients and radial gradients. In this example, we will see the linear gradient. Well, first we will install the React Native Linear Gradient module from here. Now we run the app. We need to go to the Android folder and run the gradle clean command to sync the gradle with the project. Now run the app again. The module has been added to the project correctly. Here's how to use a linear gradient. First, we import the component into the project. Well, this is how we use the component in the project. Here we replace the main view with linear gradient. The colors parameter is required for this component. And its value is an array of at least two colors that represent the colors of the gradient. To make it easier for us to find a better color combination, we use the uigradients.com, which has many proportional combinations. For example, I choose this combination for the background color of the page. Click on the color code to copy it and use it in the colors of the gradient. As you can see, the background color of the page changed to gradient. Here we can increase the colors of the gradient to 3 to make our button more noticeable. I repeat the same second color at the beginning of the array, and the result is better. Well, now we go to the button. Here we use the same previous gradient code inside the touchable opacity and change it. Well, I remove the third color from it. We go to the uigradients.com again and choose another suitable color for our work. Well, the result is good. Now let's look at some other features. By default, the gradient is applied vertically. Using the start and end parameters, we can apply the gradient horizontally. In the start parameter, we set both the values of x and y to 0. And in the end parameter, we have the value of x equal to 1 and the value of y 0. Refresh and you will see that the gradient is applied horizontally. If we want to change the position of two colors in horizontal mode, we change the value of the parameters in this way. Well, now we use the location in gradient. Locations are actually an array of numbers that determine where each gradient color stops. The order of the numbers in this array should correspond to the order of the colors array. Well, first we turn the gradient of the button vertically. Now we set the locations for these two colors. If this value is half, it means that the black color is in the middle of the gradient. Now we use the angle in the gradient. For example, we define the angle of 45 degrees and the center of rotation of the angle in the center of the button. Refresh, and as you can see, the gradient was applied at 45 degrees. We will try this for a few more angles. Well, now we want to make this button from a CSS gradient code. For CSS gradient code, go to eggradients.com. From here, we copy one of the codes and we put it in the file as a comment to use its code. Well, we will replace the two colors used in CSS with the button colors. These values are also related to the location of the colors. And finally, we replace the angle. Well, the CSS style has been transferred to our button. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please ask me in the comment section. I will be happy to help you. Don't forget to subscribe. I will see you in the next video.